So there's another way to look at this, types of value propositions, kind of as a Venn diagram. So what comes from technical insights are making things more efficient or smaller or faster, and sometimes lower cost and simpler. What comes from market insights are better distribution and bundling and branding. But sometimes what you have is this sweet spot in the middle that actually is a combination of technical and market insights that makes for a killer value proposition. So let's take a look at some examples of technical insights. There's a company called Icidia that was an outgrowth of the Stanford math department, where a PhD student said, listen, we could do a topological analysis of highly dimensional data to be analyzed without predetermining the number of feature sets. Boy, that's a mouthful, but it turns out that this is the world's best way to go through big data sets, huge data sets, in a way that was just computationally not possible before. And in fact, once they had their technical insight, they started to talk to customers about pains and gains, and it was an enormously effective product to solve problems that were so painful they just couldn't be approached before. Another example was a startup called Inscopus that mass-produced components to create a miniaturized fluorescence microscope. It turns out that this technical insight allowed them to reduce the size of a device that took up a tabletop that could now fit in your hand. And in fact, they created an entirely new market that solved problems that customers didn't even imagine until they actually saw this new device. On the other hand, there's some examples of market insight. You know, Zynga was one of the first companies to realize that people wanted to play games online that were more involved than were currently offered. They not only wanted to play solitaire, but they actually wanted to play games that involved interaction with other people. And their big insight was Facebook as the distribution channel for those games. Twitter, another example of market insight. Masses of people are more likely to write 140 characters than 1,000 words. Everybody was skeptical, but it turns out it plugged into something that was both a market and a human nature insight. It solved a need. Zipcar's insight was actually kind of interesting, is that instead of just renting cars on business trips, it might be that people in urban areas or in college campuses no longer wanted to own cars, but wanted to be able to get them with incredible flexibility, a lot more than the traditional rental car companies offered. And Zipcar actually had a market insight that made it a successful public company.